Jackie Evancho.
Jackie Evancho.
Jackie Evancho.
Jackie Evancho.
Jackie Evancho.
Jackie Evancho.
It's Jackie Evancho.
You're one of our favorite guests, Jackie.
She's gone from YouTube all the way to the top of the charts.
The moment when Jackie Evancho's career exploded.
11-year-old Jackie Evancho is about to launch a massive tour.
This is 11-year-old Jackie Evancho.
Jackie Evancho was just 10 years old when she stunned the world with her voice on NBC's America's Got Talent.
Again, with a local girl who's become a star around the world.
Jackie Evancho is known for having just an amazing voice.
The voice of an angel. This is it. If you want to hear the purest, the most genuine, the most sincere, this is it.
10-year-old Jackie Evancho's performance on America's Got Talent won the hearts of millions of viewers, taking her from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, into the national spotlight.
Please welcome Jackie Evancho.
Please welcome Jackie Evancho.
This beautiful child,
Jackie Evancho.
It was heavenly.
America is going to be going crazy for a little girl who just sang like an angel.
One of the most extraordinary performances I've ever seen.
One of those performances that I will never, ever forget.
Here is Jackie Evancho.
Saw her as a 10-year-old on America's Got Talent. This young woman with the stunning voice has embarked on a career that is one for the ages. Not only does she have 3 top 10 album debuts, she's the youngest solo artist in history ever to go platinum. Please welcome back to the stage, Jackie Evancho.
I started listening to opera a few years ago, and it was with Andrea Bocelli and Luciano Pavarotti. And somehow, I just ended up on Jackie Evancho. She was singing with Andrea Bocelli on the song Conte Partir, and it was amazing. And do you know that even the president loves her? Yeah, he really does. Check that out.
When we hear the size and the voice that comes out of the relatively small body of our singer, Jackie Evancho, God has given her an extraordinary gift, and we're thrilled she is here to share it with us. Please welcome Jackie Evancho.
Thank you.
solo, solo sogno l'orizzonte, mancano le parole. Sì, lo so che non c'ero, c'è in un istante quando manca il sole. Te non ci stai, tu con me, con me. Sulle finestre mostra tutto il mio cuore che
wow. Sorry.
Yes.
There are some Kleenexes. Just wait a few seconds. Thank you, thank you. There's so much emotion. I listen to this song and those songs. Wow. Jessica. Really emotive.
What was it like at the age of 10 to all of a sudden becoming a worldwide star?
Well, honestly, at the age of 10, I couldn't really comprehend it that much.
Right.
Now that I know what's going on and stuff, it's pretty amazing, and I never would have seen myself this far.
And now you've kept it up. You've just put out your third album.
Mm-hmm.
That's a huge accomplishment.
And she's born an hour ago with a third album.
I mean, talk about the stamina, David, you know better than anybody, required to keep up a singing career, a recording career.
You know, what's the most important thing that's happened in Jackie's life, I think, is, I mean, besides the fact that she's amazing, but she's kept her feet on the ground, literally, and she has a great manager, Mark Johnston, who happens to be my manager, too. He can't keep my feet on the ground, but he's kept her feet on the ground, and she really is a kind of a normal 14-year-old, and she's not partying, she's not getting crazy like you read about, and she's got this amazing gift, this voice that is so spectacular, and the best part about it is she really knows what to do with it. She's really educated on what her job is as a singer, because there's a lot of great voices out there, but she really knows the work, and it's amazing. She's so far beyond her years, it's good.
Be in the studio listening to your own voice back at you a million times over for every take.
You know, it's kind of like, oh my gosh, I don't think I sound good at all, and I get really stressed.
You get really, it's not necessarily just super easy for you to get up on stage and sing for everybody?
Well, it's very easy for me to get on stage, and I'm confident in myself. It's just, Because I know what that they, if they're there, they think I'm good. Yeah. So that's all I really need to know.
They don't just think you're good, though, Jackie. They think you're great.
Thank you.
So who do you look up to, then, when it comes to a vocalist?
You know, I really don't look up to a lot of people, only because I want to be able to make up my own path, rather than looking up to someone else and following theirs. So it's kind of like I just want to have my own thing. Mm-hmm. But I do look up to Emmy Rossum. I really love her. And though he's not a singer, I look up to David Foster because he is the best and very awesome and fun and successful. So.
And if he sees something in you, that means a lot, doesn't it?
Jackie and I had a brief encounter a couple of years ago on the road. I was touring and holding talent contests in each city. And she popped up. She was probably the age of 8 at that time. And that led to all this that we're doing now. I treat her absolutely like she's an adult. And she acts like an adult. She has the brain of an adult. We like to say that when she's singing the music, that she glues herself to the track that she's hearing in her headphones, and she just sort of, it sounds corny, but she just becomes one with the music. I give her direction and she just pops it like any pro that I've ever worked with. It's quite remarkable, right?
Yeah.
And you get exactly what I say. Let's go back 2 bars, let's punch in on this word. This word was flat, this thing is that, this was not quite the way I wanted. Or she'll say, can I take it from the bridge again? It's pretty amazing. She has an amazing work ethic. She just work and work and work. It was amazing. She just never stopped. She's like the little Energizer bunny.
You have to work hard to get to the spot that you want to be. You always have to have confidence in yourself. No matter where you are and whatever the situation is, you have to give it your all.
Jackie's first album that she made with artists such as David Foster and others, well, it's Prelude to a Dream. Most of the songs in this record is the songs that she used for America's Got Talent show. So we kind of see how it goes, because in 2009, the album was released, Prelude to a Dream, and in 2010, it was America's Got Talent, and she used her songs that were on Prelude to a Dream in America's Got Talent, and we also see an improvement of the voice. EP album, a Christmas EP album. And that album, EP album, is called Oh Holy Night. And it's an EP album because there's only 4 tracks in it. And so it's not really called an album, it's a full album. And it's good.
Oh Holy Night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear.
Lovers. It's my favorite song to sing right now. It's the theme to the House Flying Daggers movie. I love it so much just because of the drama in it and the emotion that you can pour out to the song. I wrote a song for this record, and it's called Dream With Me. It's about all the things in life that I think are beautiful and things that are dreamy and all. David had me write my thoughts that were dreamy on a piece of paper.
I said, you know, just take a paper and pen and just write down your thoughts. If you know, and she wrote down all these beautiful thoughts, like clouds and dreaming and seals and what else was on there?
Seashells.
Yeah, and just all her thoughts. And then we formulated them into a song. I joke about it. She's born an hour ago. She hasn't had a lot of time to think about these things, but I'm quite positive that she could be a writer. Because anybody this talented, it would just make sense, because that's just the way it goes with these people. They somehow just get an abundance of talent. I don't know how that works, but they just are good at everything. She's smart, she's likable, she's personable, she's inquisitive, she's curious, and she's fun. And she sings okay.
That reminds me of someone. I think his name's David Foster.
Awesome.
Oh Holy Night is a Christmas EP album, and Jackie also made a Christmas album, not an EP, but also a Christmas album, and it's a good album. It's called Heavenly Christmas, and it has many Christmas crossover songs, and it's wonderful. She's adorable, and I keep saying that word, but
at the age of 11,
that's when she made that album.
Jackie Evancho may be a soprano prodigy, but she's still human and gets nervous before taking the stage.
A lot of butterflies, and so when I get nervous, I just kind of pray and ask God to take away the nerves. And I get on stage and it all goes away and I feel perfectly fine afterwards.
The opera singer was discovered on America's Got Talent when she was just 10 years old. Now, 2 years later, she's got a new album called Songs from the Silver Screen, and it even features her little brother, Jacob, on a tune from the animated movie Tangled.
And at last I see the light.
It was really fun and exciting and a lot different and something that was really fun to do on stage.
But don't expect the siblings to be the new Donnie and Marie.
He gets too nervous on stage, and so he doesn't really like that feeling, so I don't know if you're gonna see a lot of him in singing. Yeah.
Awakening, I truly think it's one of the best albums that she has. Wait, I think I got the album. Let me check. Oh yes, Jackie Evancho. Yeah. So here's the album I got, Jackie Evancho, Awakening. She's on the cover. She doesn't seem like a 14-year-old, but she is. She seems more like a 21, 23-year-old girl, and her voice also seems like that, or more her voice like 30 years old, but it's amazing how she got this gift. It's incredible, honestly. And, yeah.
Think of me. Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me once in a while. Please promise me you'll try. When you find that once again you long to take your heart back and be free.
And I have to tell you, I'm so impressed with you and what you do. she doesn't even know that she has this gift. All right.
What style of singing do you do?
Classic.
And what inspired you to start singing classical? Because most 9-year-olds don't even probably know what classic is.
I'm not sure, but...
Maybe angels?
Yeah.
What will you be singing this evening?
The Miacopino card.
It's Italian, sounds Italian, okay.